We are currently on site at Hebburn Mine Water Scheme. As you can see, significant works are taking place. The scheme will provide heating, domestic hot water and electricity to Hebburn Central and Durham Court via a network of pipes and cables. We are asked frequently, how can disused mine water in the ground create heat? Well, the scheme uses geothermal energy drawn from disused and now water-filled mines, which was once Hebburn Colliery. This will be used to heat council-owned buildings in the town. To generate this heat for the buildings, water is extracted by drilling boreholes 200 to 300 metres deep into the disused coal mines. Pilot boreholes provide key information which will feed into the main scheme's design. A water source heat pump then extracts heat from the mine water before it is boosted to a higher temperature and distributed to the heat network. As part of the project, an energy centre and pump room will be located near the site in the town centre. Hebburn Central is the council leisure and community hub facility, offering a library, a 25-metre swimming pool, a gym and a multifunction hall. Durham Court is a 19-storey residential building with 111 flats. Durham Court has a considerable constant heating and hot water demand throughout the day, and this demand makes an ideal scenario to connect to the district heating system. The works are due to finish in March 2023. We are looking forward to completion, and despite some minor delays in the coal measures being deeper than expected, we are very excited that the initial results from the mine water sampling are encouraging.
South Tyneside Council is determined to lead the way in changing our future. We are committed to leading by example and driving investment in the green future. Our pledge to become carbon neutral by 2030 refers to the carbon emissions from our gas and electricity usage and our fleet fuel usage. What we have done to reduce the emissions so far is deliver significant building rationalisation programme, install solar panels to a number of council buildings, deliver a significant improvement programme of LED upgrades to street lighting with continued capital investment taking place, building modernisation retrofit improvement programme and installing combined heating and power units at some of our highest consuming sites. We are doing a lot to protect our environment and tackle climate change. We are embedding social values into procurement, increasing the amount of electric car charging points, planting around 3,000 trees a year, improving the energy and efficiency of residential accommodation, investing in flood alleviation schemes in Moncton and Clayton. And we will continue to invest and look at new ways to help change South Tyneside.
Back in 2019, South Tyneside Council declared a climate emergency. We are currently implementing strategies that will bring about real change to South Tyneside. Earlier this year, we launched our 5 community priorities. One of our priorities is to invest in our natural and built environment. We are committed to leading by example and driving investment in a green future. Our strategy goes beyond our direct carbon emissions. Our future plans include the Viking Energy Network Jarrow, the Hebburn Mine Water District Network, the Holborn Renewable Energy Network, the Middlefields Energy Scheme. The scheme will provide on-site renewable electricity energy generation to key council buildings. The continuation of our phased capital investment programme, focused on upgrading old and inefficient streetlights to LEDs. Salt marsh restoration, a project to recreate rare habitats such as salt marshes of the River Tyne, working with the Tyne Estuary Partnership. The Healing Nature Project, a project to restore priority habitats in 5 wildlife sites in the borough, working with the Durham Wildlife Trust. An awareness and engagement programme to increase understanding of the climate change across the borough and highlight what can be done to reduce its worst effects.
There's no planet B.
The climate is changing, so should we.
It's for our future.